Another very important feature of QEMU is a QEMU monitor. It is a very powerful piece of QEMU. It gives direct control over the emulated hardware. We can like add processors, add memory. To be honest, this QEMU monitor has all the features that any professional cloud provider would need, and even more. So it's very, very sophisticated. It gives ability to look into memory directly. But in this training, we will not explore it very deeply. It is very easy to find documentation about all the features. Let's just show like typically what firmware developers use. They typically check, for example, if QEMU with coreboot hanged at some point. We check what kind of registers, what's the state of the registers, where's the stack pointer, where's the instruction pointer. So I will show you how to dump registers. There are some additional features like enabling GDB server to hook into QEMU, but this will be discussed further. But at this point, let's discuss how to connect QEMU monitor. So to enable QEMU monitor, we can use various different methods. We can use standard I/O, we can use like multiple different methods, but in our case we will use Unix sockets, and then we'll use socket to connect to that Unix socket and have some fun using QEMU monitor. So the process is not very trivial. We're running QEMU with monitor parameters, defining where is the socket location, some parameters for socket, and then we because we already use default output of QEMU, which is saturated with coreboot logs. We somehow have to hook into the system. That's why we just opening another terminal. We're looking for our container. Because QEMU is already in container, we have to enter the container and find the socket, like connect to the socket. Then we can explore QEMU monitor commands. So let's try that. So let's just execute the monitor. Of course, as it was showed on last slide, we're just adding to that alias monitor Unix with the path to the Unix socket. Of course, this would be server and some parameters for the socket. So we're running. Let's switch to second terminal. We need a cinema here also. And what we have to do here is identify the Docker container in which we run this QEMU session. So first, let's list what kind of Dockers I'm running. This is the ID of the container. So let's execute some interactive command in this container. We are inside. So now we should be able to use socket command for hooking into the socket exposed by the QEMU. As you can see, we are in QEMU monitor. There are multiple commands here. You can see like how rich this environment is. I even don't know all the possibilities here, but what's important for basic exploration of the possibilities of QEMU monitor is info command. Info command is very important and show quite a lot of information about the system. First of all, it can show information about the processor. It can do the dumps. It can do perform some interesting reports about interrupts, APIs, about virtualization, about memory. But what I want to show you here is, for example, registers. And as you can see, we are probably in a 16-bit mode where our CBIOS trying to handle some disks. But you can see that it also changed during the execution. So you can find the stack pointer, you can find instruction pointer, and bunch of other interesting things. There's also TPM information. If you have any TPMs hooked, you can also look at the structure of the emulated device, emulated system, using Q3. Q3 shows in a kind of three level what kind of devices with which parameters are emulated in this system. And thanks to that, you can see like where is the MMIO for this device, and bunch of like how the base address registers are configured, and bunch of other important information when you're doing development. Feel free to explore this command even more. It's very interesting, and definitely it is worth to learn more about it.